Mac!
Just like a dream, with the warmth that's in your eyes when you look at me. I hear your voice beside me, it whispers to me. I can't hide how it makes me feel, the shyness you see. Understand how deep it goes, but I know how I feel, what I hold deep in my heart. There's just no way to stop this, it's hopeless but true. I feel this love more than anything, so what more can stronger than I am. But then I feel the boldness that's inside my heart just melt away. How I feel for you and what I wanna say keeps getting locked inside. I like to know.
There will always be by my side. What you are into something so cool in this life of mine that I...
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to wake you.
I dreamed you were singing. At least I thought I was dreaming. Were you really singing?
No. Yeah, it's not something I do in front of people normally.
Well, what? What happened to your eyes?
My eyes?
The color's different. What's going on?
I had a dream.
You mean your memories?
Yes. Somehow, protecting you and releasing all that magic energy, it might have released the seal upon my memories as well. After all, I did seal off my own memories.
You remember? That's great! What's wrong? Are you upset about something that happened?
Huh?
Kaim really hated his memories. He said they were nothing but painful.
As painful as it is, I think it's my duty to regain these memories.
Duty? What do you mean?
Kaim likely had much more involvement with other people than I. He has seen much more of life and death. The wait of 1,000 years can indeed be painful. But I want to look back carefully at all of those years.
Wow, 1,000 years. That's really long. I can see how it could be bad. You know, have everything change except for yourself, that would be hard. You are incredible. To live 1,000 years, simply incredible. I can't even imagine. Here, have some food. This was all there was. It's not fit for a queen, but you know, it's keep your strength up.
Thank you. Shall we eat?
I'm okay. You go ahead. You need to get your strength back. You must be exhausted. You had to use a lot of magic energy to protect me.
But as a result, I finally know who I am. Thanks to you.
Well, yeah, you know, I did what I had to do there. I just kind of sat there and you basically protected me. Gee, that was really embarrassing, actually. Oh, man. I don't want to remember that.
Well, Your Majesty, what will you do? All of your precious subjects shall now become fodder for Arthrosaurus to feed on. Everything they have built, their town, culture, history, their lives, their meager happiness, all shall literally be crushed under their feet. Only you can stop this, Your Majesty. Me, Noamara.
Why have you done this? Do you have no compassion at all?
You realize, of course, that while you stand here, oh, even more of your people have been slaughtered.
Gongora, you monster!
You and I have an eternity. But do you have time to hesitate, Your Majesty? Are you deaf to their screams?
All right. What must I do?
It's times like these that immortals are so inconvenient. I can't very well take your life. However, whether one chooses to live as a walking corpse or to throw one's life away, the end result is the same.
What are you talking about?
You will seal off your memories.
What?
Your magic energy is very powerful. Use it to hypnotize yourself and lock your memories away. If you do so, I shall halt Arthrosaurus.
You coward.
You have only two choices here.
Your Majesty, please, we must hurry.
Who are you? And why do you address me as Your Majesty?
Because you are the Queen of Noamara.
I am? Truly? Been brought back for my people.
It up?
Let's go look for Kaim and the others.
We need clues. What should we do?
Well, how about we take another approach?
Like what?
Well, Kaim and Sarah were on the magic train following Cook and Mac, right?
Yes. They were eastbound, I think.
So if Kaim and Sarah were heading east, then we should go this way.
Yes, and Cook and Mac were off to find the Aurora to meet the souls of the deceased.
Right, to find the spirit of their mother.
Cook! What happened to Kaim and Sarah? They're immortal. They can't die, right?
That's what immortal means! Get up, Cook! We gotta keep moving!
I can't move.
Cook! Get up!
What is it?
I heard a voice.
A voice? Whose?
I don't know.
Maybe the wind sounded like a voice. Well, if you say it was a voice, then it was.
Strength. Give us your light for the lives of your children.
Yes, yes. Good.
Aunt May.
Okay, good, good.
Oh, thank goodness.
Aunt Sam.
You're all right. It's okay.
Thank you.
It's okay.
Thank you, Aunt May.
All right, let's go.
Jensen.
Oh. What's going on?
Whoa!
Oh. No. Oh, fine. Damn! Another leftover to deal with. Hey, you all right?
I'm okay.
What happened to Kaim and Sarah? Weren't you together?
Has something happened to them?
They were trying to help us when the train derailed,
It slammed into a huge wall of ice.
There was an explosion. That's all we saw. That they might be dead.
No way. They're immortals. Hey, you're joking, right?
Even immortals can feel pain.
Pain?
If an explosion is powerful enough, it may inflict great pain on the spirit. This pain might be more damaging than the loss of a physical body.
They're immortals. I know they gotta be alive. I mean, whoever heard of a dead immortal? Let's go look for them.
Yeah, let's look for them. Aunt Ming, what about the captain?
Oh, Seth?
Right. Yeah, she's gotten into some trouble of her own.